Hi and welcome in this new video where I will show you what happens when Apache Spark uses partition by method. As you can see in my input I have different data that I will partition by column called word. And as you can see I start with A after B, C, C, and once again I have the data, the row with partition A. And normally if you take a look at the partitioner used to write the data, which is more exactly dynamic partition data writer. Every time it starts by, at every row, it starts by comparing current partition and current bucket with new partition and new bucket. And if these values are different, it creates a new writer. New writer, which is normally the object responsible for physically writing current record. And I will try to show you with this debugging message that this writer is always the same, even though in the input data set we have different values. So we don't have consecutive values for every partition. And to do that, I'm using a sample, one CPU and one partition for Apache Spark test. And we'll now run the code. And as you can see, Apache Spark, before writing the rows, did some kind of sorting, because as you can see here, despite of having different entries, Spark started by writing the first one with one instance of output writer, another one here, and later he did the same. He did the same for the partition B, and you can see that at the end it will continue like that. And after that, I will show you that it really happened. So globally, we don't retrieve the files with a single line. So the code terminated, and now I will check the partitioned data. Yes, I did a mistake. It was not that directory. Okay. And as you can see, I have multiple rows in a single file. And the same happened for partition B, for instance, which has also multiple rows. For partition A, unfortunately, since I had only one row in the input, I have a single line in the file, but it's normal. And all this to say that Apache Spark has a built-in mechanism to prevent against writing too small amount of data in partition, and all that thanks to this kind of sorting before calling the partition by method. I will show you more detail. I explain this aspect more in detail in the article linked in the description of this video. It was Bartosz Konieczny from waitingforcode.com. Thanks for watching.